Hi guys and dolls, back again talking more about the old Google and the old Google Plus. So let's see what we want to talk about today. So again, if you're on Google and you sign in, like if you have a Gmail account, okay, and you sign in, you should have these different things up here, okay? You can very easily get Google Plus if you haven't already. You just, you know, go in and sign up for it, because if you have a Gmail, you have a Google Plus. So anyway, let's go over here to the profile. And again, this is the profile page, okay? This is your home. Let me pop off of that again. See, it says home over there. So this is like your home page. We've talked about profile. We've talked about circles, you know, which is the people section. Let's talk about some photos today, shall we? Because a lot of people are wanting to always do, you know, privacy or whatever. Now, what you'll see here is that, you know, this was a hangout that I was in and some people posted their photos there. This was a post actually that I made using a photo. And it gives the date, you can see up there. And then as I scroll down, this is on my page, okay? My other page, that's the plus.google.com/WesleyGW, okay? So that's on that one. These are ones that I've posted over there. And then you'll see down here different images that I posted and the dates that I posted them, okay? So let's say right here, for some reason, this photo, I want to make sure that it's private, okay? Obviously, hopefully you know what a tag is, okay? That's where you can tag, you know, someone's name in it. So I clicked it. What happened? Alrighty. Interesting. All right, and then you can, of course, share, okay? And what I'm going to do is go ahead and click that little drop down looking thing. You can add photos, your sharing options, you can download the photo, okay? So like if you went to someone else's, like if you came to my thing and you wanted this Coke picture, you could download that Coke picture. You can add a picture to an event, you can move it to the trash, okay? So what we're gonna do, let's look at sharing options here. And this is the album that it's in, all right, and the date. And then this right here shows you, you know, the different people that you can share it with. And of course, you can take them off and you can add just individual people, or you can add different circles. Okay. And then show your location data. You know, that's going to be something that you want to be really aware of. Like if you're taking family pictures, that you live in your hometown and you have children, that has been shown a way that bad people, shall we say, can find out where you are and where your children are. And then, of course, if you just want to share the link of the image, you can do that as well, okay? So let's just click on the picture, too, okay? Well, before I do that, let me go back. All that was just found under here, under sharing options, okay? Under the little caret thingy with sharing options. So again, if we want to just look at the picture itself, okay, and this is not a picture that I took. I found this online somewhere, but I'm just wanting to show y'all different things. So, like, this is the post. It was on October 17th of 2013, and this is what I said, and this is a link I put in, and then I put the photo in there, all right? So what you can do, of course, you can share it, all right, just like normal. It's like if I wanted to renew that for some reason, you can do that. You can edit it. That's a new thing. And edit as much as you want, okay? And then here I'm just showing you the different editing tools, okay? Different imaging, adjusting, cropping, and rotating. It's kind of like, think of like an Instagram, sort of. You can put frames on it, you know, tilt, shift, and all that kind of stuff, all right? So these are all different, these are all different editing options that you can do, okay? So I'm gonna click done. You can't see it because it's down below the screen capture window, but right below this blue check it says done editing. So I'm going to click that, and it took me back here. Tag people, okay? So it says click on a face to tag that person, just like in Facebook. Like if this was a person, I could click it and then I could put their name in here, okay? And then slideshow, that's just going to be, you know, obviously playing your different pictures in a slideshow so you can see them. And then when you click the more thing, you can add it to a different album. You can set it as a cover photo. You can download the photo again, auto enhance, normal high and off. I never mess with that. And then highlight, okay? Now, over here, you can always turn it. See, it turned it sideways, and it will show up that way always at this point, okay? And then I want to turn it back. And then, of course, you've got zooming in and cropping and then putting it in the trash as well. Okay. I'm trying to see here if, let me see if I can make it a little smaller so it'll fit in the screen. It's not going to show y'all this down here at the bottom, but basically right below here is an arrow one way or the other that you can look at all your different photos from your posts. Okay. Now, whoopsie, that was not what I wanted to do. Okay, had to go back and get the picture again. All right. So now on the, I think it's in the share part. No, it is not in the share part. Okay, sorry for the jump cut there, but I was wanting to find something. Something came to my mind that we'll go over here in a minute. But basically, if you recall, like this in particular is an album. Okay, this is set up as an album. And then these are going to be all in one section, but each of these individual ones are not. Okay. Now, you know, a lot of times people want to know how do you, you know, how do you make it private or whatever. And the only thing, again, is in your sharing and when you did the original post, okay, on the sharing over here. Anybody that you put in this area is going to be who can see it. So, for example, if I only wanted, you know, two people in my family to see it, then I would only do that. Those would be the only people that could see it, okay? But otherwise, basically, there's really no way to hide all of your pictures from everybody at all times. But again, my question is, if you want that privacy, then why are you putting your photos online? So I know that's kind of weird and kind of a backwards way of thinking about it maybe, but that's really to me what makes most sense. So again, if you have a family photo, you know, you may only want to do family and, you know, friends or something like that in getting to see your photos. Okay. So having said that, that's it for the individuals. Now, one way that you can help a little bit is back again over here. Right now it says photos, but remember on like the home page, it'll say home at the top or whatever. So wherever you are, just go to this drop down menu to settings, click that, and then look for these bolded headlines. And again, this is February 2014, so this may look different by the time you're looking at it, but look right here, okay, for the bolded headlines. And you'll see about manage subscription, receive notifications, apps, circles, accessibility. Come to the section that says photos and videos and take a look at that, okay? If you check these, you know, these are going to be things that can be seen. Geolocation information on newly uploaded photos and videos. Again, that gets into if you have a picture at the park with your children and there's any kind of landmark shown in the background, Creepy McCreepersons can find out where you live if you let geolocation be on there. Parents, if you have teenagers, you want to make sure that this is not checked, again, so your teenager cannot be found by a Creepy McCreeperson, okay? Allow viewers to download my photos and videos. If you do not want that to be able to be done, you need to make sure it's not checked, okay? Otherwise, an innocent picture of you, you know, of your baby, 20 years ago, maybe your baby's turning 20, and you post a baby photo of them, anybody can download that photo if you have this checked, okay? Find my face in photos and videos and prompt people I know to tag me. I have this checked because it's for business purposes, all right? And it's for those kind of purposes for that reason. If you do not want that ability to happen, then you would want to uncheck that. Basically, you can look at this almost like, you know, Big Brother and facial recognition, because, you know, that's what computers do, is that they, you know, basically do a face, you know, mapping, and they can find you even if it is in somebody's, you know, travel video, they were on vacation and you're in the background, okay? And if you show up in a photo or a video, then you could, that could be prompted. So again, consider this checking or unchecking. Upload your photos at full size. You know, you can do that. Turning on full size uploads will slow down your uploads, okay? So I don't have that checked because I'm not worried about it being big. This is a lot for people that are photojournalists and things like that, that they would want to make sure that they have uploads at full size, and other people too, but just in general, you know, that would be that kind of a thing here. And then of course, you know, just go through here and check the rest of these things. And then note down here, you know, check your Google Drive, the auto enhance, auto awesome. And then note this, people whose tags of you are automatically approved to be added to the photos of you section of your profile. So I've allowed anybody in my circle, circles, you know, any of those, that it's automatically approved if they tag a photo of me. Okay, so check that out again, and then, you know, there's tons and tons of settings, so you'll need to check that out. And I will actually do a video on settings, probably, I'm thinking. Yes, I'm going to do a video on settings in the next video. So I hope this helps you know a little bit more about how to use Google Plus and about how to use the photos in particular. And on that, have a delicious, delightful, delirious day, and I will see you tomorrow.